Hello students, so in our DME class today we will discuss clutches. A clutch is a machine member used to connect a driving shaft to a driven shaft so that driven shaft may be started or stopped at will without stopping the driving shaft. So whenever we want to change gears in a car or an automobile, we have to engage or disengage the driving shaft with the propeller shaft, and this thing we want to do quickly without stopping the driving shaft. So to achieve this, we use the clutches. The use of clutch is mostly found in automobiles. A little consideration will show that in order to change gears, it is required that driven shaft should be disengaged but the engine should continue to run. So it is therefore necessary that driven shaft should be disengaged from the driving shaft. The engagement and disengagement of the shafts is obtained by means of clutch, which is operated by a lever. So clutch, first of all, we will discuss the friction clutch and then we will discuss the cone clutch, because in your syllabus there are friction clutches and cone clutches. The force of friction is used to start the driven shaft from the rest and gradually brings it up to the proper speed without excessive slipping of the friction surfaces. In automobiles, friction clutch is used to connect the engine to the drive shaft. In operating such a clutch, care should be taken so that friction surfaces engage easily and gradually bring the driven shaft up to proper speed. Properties of material for clutch surfaces. So these are some properties. It should have a high and uniform coefficient of friction. It should not be affected by moisture and oil. It should have ability to withstand high temperature caused by slippage. It should have high heat conductivity. It should have high resistance to wear. So this is the diagram for the single disc or plate clutch. So first of all, we have driving shaft, which is connected to engine. Then we have flywheel, which is rotating with the driving shaft. Then we have this pressure plate or clutch plate, whose design we will discuss. Then we have this pressure plate. Now this is our body, and then springs. In the center we have driven shaft, hub, and this lever to press the pedal. So whenever we press the pedal, the springs contract and the clutch is disengaged and the driving shaft and driven shaft are disconnected. But whenever we release the pedal, the springs extends and the pressure plate apply the pressure on the clutch plate to attach it with the flywheel, and the power it transmitted from the driving shaft to the driven shaft, and the engine will power will be supplied to the wheels and your vehicle will move. So a single disc or plate clutch consists of a clutch plate whose both sides are faced with a friction material. So this is your clutch plate, and its both sides are faced with friction material. The pressure plate is mounted inside the clutch body, which is bolted to the flywheel. Both the pressure plate and flywheel rotate with engine crankshaft or the driving shaft. The pressure plate pushes the clutch plate towards the flywheel by a set of strong springs which are engaged radially inside the body. So now we will discuss the design of disc or plate clutch. So now consider two friction surfaces maintained in contact by an axial thrust W. So this is your axial thrust W, and the outside radius is R1, inside radius is R2. This is your single disc or plate, and pressure applied is P. So this is your side view. Outside radius is R1, inside radius is R2. And we assume a strip or ring of radius R and thickness dr. So let torque T transmitted by the clutch, small p is the pressure, R1 outside radius, R2 inside radius, R is the mean radius, mu is coefficient of friction. So consider an elementary ring of radius R and thickness dr. We know that area of the contact surfaces or friction surfaces 2 pi r into dr. So the area of the strip is, the circumference is 2 pi r and thickness is dr. Therefore, normal or axial force on the ring, that is delta W, is pressure into area. So this area is multiplied by pressure to calculate load. Now friction force on the ring acting tangentially at radius r. Now load is calculated. If it multiply it with mu, then we get got the friction force. And friction force is mu p 2 pi r dr. And torque is friction force into radius. So multiply the F into R, that is mu p 2 pi r into dr into R is the torque. So this is the formula for the torque on the strip. We shall now consider the following two cases. Now whenever you discuss the design of the clutches, you will apply two theories. One is uniform pressure theory and other one is uniform wear theory. When your clutch is new, you will apply the uniform pressure theory. But when your clutch is old, then you will apply the uniform wear theory. So first of all, we will discuss uniform pressure theory. Pressure is load upon area. So pressure is load W upon area is pi outside radius minus inside radius square. So we have discussed that formula for torque is 2 pi mu p r square into dr. We integrate it because this is the torque transmitted by the strip. But we want the total torque transmitted, so we will integrate it from R2 to R1. So after integration, we will solve these equations. You can check the integration. You will get this relation 2 by 3 mu w R1 cube minus R2 cube by R1 square minus R2 square. And we can write it as mu w into R. Because R, we can say R is 2 by 3 R1 cube minus R2 cube by R1 square minus R2 square is your R, which is the mean radius of the friction surfaces. So the formula for torque transmitted T is mu WR, where R is this mean radius of the friction surface. This is the case of uniform pressure theory. Now we will discuss uniform wear theory. So it is a little bit of attention is needed here. It may be noted that when the friction surface is new, there is uniform pressure distribution over the entire contact surface. As we have discussed, when your clutch is new, you will apply the uniform pressure theory. This pressure will wear most rapidly where the sliding velocity is maximum, and this will reduce pressure between the friction surfaces. Wearing in process continues until the product PV is constant over the entire surface. After this, the wear will be uniform. So what does it say is when you bring the clutch new, the pressure is uniform over the entire surface, but this radius R1 is greater. Due to the greater outer radius, R2 is small, R1 is large. So due to high radius at the outside surface, the velocity, sliding velocity will also be high at R1. Because sliding velocity is high at R1 and less at R2, therefore your clutch will start to wear at R1 quickly than R2. So after this, your clutch will wear in this way, and this will continue until the wear is uniform over the entire surface. That is, product of pressure and velocity is constant. Till then, the your wear will occur at the outer radius much more than the inner radius. So what will happen after that? Once your clutch wears until the point the wear is uniform over the entire surface. So you can see here the pressure is reduced and here the pressure is maximum. So at R1, the pressure will be reduced because the clutch surface has been weared out. And at R2, pressure is less because your clutch surface is not weared out that much. So let small p is the normal intensity of pressure at distance r from the axis of the clutch. Since intensity of pressure varies inversely with the distance, so you can see pressure is inversely proportional to radius. At R2, pressure is high. At R1, pressure is less. So pressure is inversely proportional to radius. We can write it as pressure is equal to constant upon r. Rest of the things we will discuss in the next part. Thank you, students.